All set. Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, Riley, if you could kick it into gear. Huh? I flew here from San Diego.
Yeah, I had to clear a busy schedule.
I'm good. I would love a beer. I'm almost done this one. Are we playing the song? What's up, guys? Welcome to a special live edition of The Plunge. Joining me, as always, is Riley T. Say what's up, dude.
Yep.
And Just Dave.
That's me. Hi.
We are the number one potato podcast, your fourth favorite hosts on the East Coast. Fourth.
Yeah.
The number one hockey podcast south of the border, and the number one religious equestrian podcast north of the Mason-Dixon line.
Let's dive in. Live from Curlies Comedy Club, Rochester, New Hampshire. Thank you all for coming out. Woo!
Thank you.
Yeah. A special shout out to Curlies for putting on Pod-Tober. We're wrapping up the month. PodcastNH put on 5 shows this month here at Curlies, and we're thankful enough to wrap it up. So thank you guys for allowing us to put this on, and thank you all for coming out.
Yeah, that's one more than four.
More than four. We have a full show planned for you guys.
Yeah.
A full show.
No half show?
No half show.
Okay.
Not even 3/4. A whole show.
I see you guys are stickered up. You selling the brand?
Yeah. For the brand, brother. Gotta stay on brand.
Cold. Now, Hunter, I gotta say, you're rocking a mean mustache tonight.
Yeah. As you all know, November's coming up. And every year, The Plunge does fundraise for Movember, which is general men's health awareness and prostate cancer. So, if it's not donating to us, please find an organization to donate to support those causes.
Oh, yeah. Now, before we get too deep into this episode, do you guys like to fuck?
I do, but it doesn't happen often.
All right, we got a large black man choking on chicken wings in the front row.
This guy fucks. This guy.
Pure sex.
Pure.
Now, if you're a man who likes, finger licking good sex, all right, we have the deal for you. Now, when you use promo code PLUNGE at AdamandEve.com, we're gonna give you 50% off.
50%.
50% off. That's half off all of your favorite toys. All right, that's sex toys, lingerie, anything you guys want, we got it. 50% off. And you know what? Just this month only, we are giving 10 free items with it.
Yeah. 10.
We're pretty much putting stuff back into your pockets. Even sex wings? Especially
sex wings.
You
can order one. Don't be a cheap fuck, Taylor.
So, go to adamandeve.com, use code PLUNGE, and you will get 6 free spicy movies, spicier than Taylor's finger-licking, choking wings. Okay, yeah, he's got the live stream going. He's showing the wings. On top of that, 6 free movies, 3 special gifts, a mystery pack, and free shipping.
Yeah, that's an item for him, an item for her, and an item that both of you can enjoy.
Oh, yeah, that's both of us, buddy.
Yeah, both of us.
We're going to have a good time.
Yeah. So AdamandEve.com, promo code PLUNGE. Get your fuck on. While we're talking about, Adam and Eve stuff, I had something happen to me.
I'm ready.
Yesterday. And
if it's about sex, I don't believe it.
It's mildly. So the ladies in here might be able to relate to this more. I was just hanging out yesterday, sitting at the bar, and I got an unsolicited nude. And it bothered me.
Did you file a report?
It was great, too, but I was like, what the fuck is this? I'm in public.
Sorry, you are, yeah.
I know. Can you believe they're just out here sending unsolicited body parts? Like, no man would ever do that. No man would ever be like, oh, this is nice. Let me send it to a woman without consent.
You know what you should have done? Send an unsolicited nut pic.
That is the ultimate power move right there.
Right? Assert your dominance.
No dick, just nut?
Just nut.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's the new wave.
So I'm here to fight back unsolicited nudes. We're doing no nude November, men, okay? To all the men out there. No more D's.
Can't do it.
Okay. No.
Yeah, I didn't sign up for that.
Yeah. It's just unbelievable. Also, speaking of bars, though.
Yeah.
So last week, if you guys are Plunge listeners, I talked about how me and my roommate, Shane, we're going to become regulars at Applebee's.
Yes.
How's that going?
We got cut off from Applebee's this weekend.
Wait, what time, though? Like 2 a.m.?
We got cut off at Applebee's at 10 p.m.
Okay. Would you have two margaritas?
No, we had two $1 drinks. Okay. And then they said, no more, guys.
Are you serious?
Is that true? They told us there it's a three-drink limit. I've had much more than three drinks at Applebee's before.
Depends on who you get served.
All right, well, I'm not here for these people who are limiting me at Applebee's. The Applebee's is supposed to be for fun. It's supposed to be for loving, relaxing, your friendly neighborhood ABs, you know?
Dude, it's a family restaurant.
And they're cutting me off at three drinks. Because, I would have been out here. I would have been out here promoting for Applebee's. I would have been all for Applebee's. I would have been like, hey, guys, free ads, go to Applebee's. I had three appetizers and six drinks for $19.99. But no, you know what I'm saying tonight instead? Fuck Applebee's. No more Applebee's. Yeah.
So does this mean they're on the list with...
This man also agrees. He says, fuck Applebee's. You. Cheers to you.
Hypothetically... I know someone who is underage and had a fake ID, and they definitely sell more than three drinks. Holy. It was me, and they definitely served me more than three drinks.
All right.
So if you have a pedophile mustache, they won't cut you off at Applebee's.
No.
Best part about that, last year I had a pedophile mustache.
Is this just a part of your look?
Yeah, I was about to say, you're coming back to it now. What's going on, man?
I couldn't stay away, man.
Yo. Okay. All right.
It's a life for you.
Yeah. Beautiful crowd.
Now... Dave, you've become a new member of the show, really.
I've been reborn. We can say that.
Reborn?
I guess so, yeah. If you want to put it that way.
Rebirth is the theme of tonight.
Now, Dave, I have a little clip that I want to know your thought on. I have this song. So, as many of you know, the ABC song is something we were raised on. Yeah. Okay? And do you guys know it? Shh. You hold... Everyone want to sing along with me?
Wait. What's your favorite letter? Because mine's LMNOP.
Oh, boy. You're going to hate this next video.
Yikes.
So, as we all know, the ABC song, A, B, C, D, E, F, G,
H, I, J, K, LMNOP, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X,
I don't know what comes after Y.
Now I know my ABCs.
No,
you know. Thank you.
My man.
Now, they changed it, and it is bullshit, and we're going to listen to it together.
The name is bullshit.
They changed it. You guys ready?
Wait, they changed it?
It's gonna piss you off.
A, B, C, D, E, I hate this already. F, G.
Alright, we're going good. It's fine so far.
With it.
J, K, L, M, N,
yeah.
O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V,
Y.
W,
oh my
X,
God.
Y, Z.
Imagine graduating college and not knowing the alphabet. A semester early at that.
Cheers to a state degree.
Nah.
Now, Dave, what do you think about that?
I think we need to find out who made that.
The hard L. The hard L is not good.
Not good at all. Look, there's a lot of things not good with that.
Approved. That joke was approved.
My man. Look. I'm just saying we need to find out whoever made that. We're not going to say exactly what we're going to do to them. But they're not going to be around to sing that song anymore. I'm just going to say that. That is horrible. And that's being sung in elementary schools?
That's being sung all over.
That's what's wrong with America.
The next generation of podcasters, they're going to sing about the next change. Yeah. And they're going to be like, Z-Y-L.
They're just going to have a...
M-N-O.
They're going to have a stroke.
Did we just become the number one alphabet podcast?
I don't know what names we would have for that.
We got Riley R, Hunter H, and David D.
Did you just say Dave B?
David D.
Oh, okay.
No, but shout out Joby from the Joby Show.
Shout out, brother.
So, Hunter, are you going to be teaching your... Is your RX things, your drug stuff, going to be any different now?
Do you want to tell everyone what you're doing right now?
Not really.
Okay. All right, he's in school to be a pharmacist. Everyone's give him a hand of applause. Everyone, he's going to be a pharmacist. If you want some Zannies at half price, you give them a call.
And that is live for the world to see.
Yeah, I hope you didn't get kicked out of that. Sorry, buddy.
Joke's on you guys. I didn't even get accepted.
I sat in this chair being like, yeah, I'm going to reign supreme to you guys.
Nope.
But then yeah, I but sat now you and just realized my silly. Mic is the same height yeah. as you, so I'm like down here.
Yeah, 5 foot four Hunter.
Is this what it's like to be short, Hunter?
I mean, I'm not even the shortest one in here.
That's just not a fact.
That is
all.
A lie. You are lying.
No, people can check.
Thank you.
Man, this
5'2", right?
Up.
Can we confirm?
I'm going to report you to the nearest school superintendent, and you are going to get kicked out of school.
He's not allowed near school.
Oh. Okay. Intern Tuba all might right. have just gotten a promotion nah. from the crowd. shout out to the whole Plunge team coming out tonight. We got intern Band Tuba, who we made make a rare appearance tonight.
Yeah, why?
He bought a ticket.
Yeah. That's fair game. I'll give
well,
him
Well, speaking
yeah.
of buying tickets.
Yeah.
You know.
You say it, man. You, say
you know
it.
Where I can get tickets?
Where can you
get bet
really?
Tickets? You
oh.
know?
Oh.
Oh.
For, like, sports?
For sports. For gambling.
For seeing
stuff?
If Queen Elizabeth is dead yet?
Ooh. What is the odds on Queen Elizabeth dying?
I believe
dying?
It's like 20 to 1.
Is there prop bets on there? Anyone want to take a bet with Dave when the Queen's
I've already
die?
Put $20 down. Who wants to join? Joe, you're on? All right, let's go.
We're making a Taylor? Prop bet. The odds let's are 400 go. To 1, but you got 2 weeks.
Y'all are
two
fucking weeks? Degenerates.
Are you re-upping?
Yeah, let's make a date right
are
now.
Are you re-upping?
Yeah, I'll do $50.
All right,
let's
this
go,
is
man.
This is the I'll second annual 50, Dave betting on the Queen's death bet.
She will die November 12th. 2019, you have my word on it.
I'm gonna need a time.
You're gonna need a time?
Time.
I feel like a day is pretty good, but I'll give you a time for fun. I'm gonna
time
say,
and you get 2 times your profit.
Oh, double down?
Double down.
Okay. 11:58 a.m. She's gonna eat her breakfast. Choke on that right there.
You really think the Queen's gonna be sleeping in?
Oh, yeah. Dude, she's
yeah,
old.
The Queen wakes up at 4:30 sharp and eats.
Yeah, but she goes to bed at like 11:30 a.m. I'm getting reported.
He's not
I'm
su-
definitely getting reported.
No, no, no. He's not suspect. He's rich because that
exactly.
payout is huge. All right, and you know where you can make bets like this is mybookie.ag. All right,
you can my bookie.
So
that's
if you go
like $100. That's like buku bucks.
So if you go to mybookie.ag, use code plunge. They're gonna match your first deposit. Okay. Now that's a lot.
What?
All right. So you can make bets on football. Why sit on the couch and have no stakes in the game when you can put all the stakes on the game? You want to win. I told all my friends bet on the Dolphins last night. You know what the Dolphins did?
Wow.
They lost, but they covered the spread, Brad. They covered
the spread.
They and did. That bet paid we're out.
We're clapping
right?
for that.
Now, if you God listen damn. To me every week, I'm going to give you guys a recommendation. We're going to get you rich, all right? With mybookie.ag, put in your first deposit. Code plunge will match your first deposit, all right? Get that money. Ooh, someone's texting me.
Ooh. I think it was Joe. Yeah.
You up?
You up? It's like 7:45. Who's up at this ungodly hour?
Shout out to a lot of the other audience, though. We got B-Team, Bin, C-Team, Kyle. Griffin is our friend. Jason Almey.
Griffin!
Just the front. Just the front. We got the Team Almey in the house. Even though they got a baby, they found a sitter or something and made their way out tonight.
Thank you for coming out.
She's out
of the car.
All right, someone head out there with a brick. We're going to save baby Almy.
No. If you need a babysitter, I think this speaks enough.
He's certified.
I'm certified.
I got a felon that lives next door. I'd rather.
Oh,
right. You do live
yeah,
in Summersworth.
Yeah, that's me. I'm the felon next door.
Well, isn't Summersworth where they just send all felons? They're like, yeah, this is where you can live.
The entire sex offender
register. Yeah. The neighbors don't actually have to go to your door and tell them you're a sex offender. You have to go to theirs and say you're not. Hey, my name is Jason, and I'm actually not a sex offender despite living in Summersworth.
He gets interrupted 4 to 5 times a day.
It's like, I'm just trying to put my baby down. These sex offenders keep knocking on my door.
Trick or treat will be fun. You're gonna have a blast.
That was the point I realized I'm an adult now. Is yeah. I have to go get candy for trick or treat.
Fucking yep. same.
Dude. I live in a poor side of town. I'm feeding these kids for weeks.
I'm dude, I'm gonna get real fucked up and just hand out candy. I want to be.
Yikes.
Well, if I hand out full-size bars, these kids ain't leaving, all right?
True.
Speaking
of they're going to go back to their parents and be like, I live there now.
Speaking of full-size bars, has anybody else seen the video of President Trump just putting full-size candy bars on a kid's head and then, like, moving them along?
I did not. No, I've seen other stuff with kids, but not that. I'm sorry. My bad.
My bad, that one's on me.
I'll take the heat for that one. 2v1 in?
I'm going to need more of these if this keeps going in this direction. But Halloween, you guys do Halloween?
What part of Halloween are we talking like?
All of it.
Or,
you dress up?
You know, I mean, maybe at night.
Halloween's great at our age because...
feel a little something, I don't know.
Halloween is great at our age because everyone's a hoe and it's awesome.
It really...
Watch your fucking mouth, I'm a whore.
You got that extra letter in horse? Yeah.
I don't think you know how to spell whore.
Every costume just has slutty in front of it, and there's nothing better.
And you can make anything slutty.
Oh, I'm going to be a slutty cafeteria lady.
Slutty cafeteria
Go on.
Lady. Slutty mortician. Slutty mortician. Tuba's words, yeah. He's back on the ban list, though.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Fucking beat me to it. No, I'm going to be a slutty Canadian this year.
Oh. How would you do that?
I have jean cutoffs, and I'm going to cut a hole for my dick to hang out.
You going to cover yourself in syrup, or?
I'm already sticky enough.
Yeah.
Ugh. Yeah, you get that.
I don't like that.
I don't like that either. But that's what the Canadians do, and we can certify that, right?
I did have a last-second costume the other day.
Yeah.
10 out of 10 idea.
Someone called me, and they're like, hey, what are you dressing up as tonight? And I had to leave soon. I was like, oh, I didn't think this was a costume party. So I put a trash bag on, and I wrote the word men on it.
Did you write your, like...
it took
me a bit to get that.
Yeah, when people asked what I was, I just said I was men, and it took them a second. And then every girl would just be like, because men are trash. I'd be like, yeah, you're getting it now, honey.
Did you get negative laid that night? Like, did you lose one...
Honestly, I went to the bar, and the results were great, but then I didn't want to be at the bar anymore. So I went home and slept.
Okay.
Because sleep is better than sex.
Most things are. Well, you're back to D team.
Yeah.
We do have. Shout shouts himself out.
We do have a full house, though, tonight. So thank you guys all for coming out. I know it's an hour away for most of us. We're from Manchester, a lot of us. So thank you all for making the trip out to support us. All the proceeds. That we're making from tonight are going straight to the Special Olympics of New Hampshire. So that's going to go to a big cause.
Every single one of you is beautiful.
That's it. Have a good night, everybody.
I did get an email today from the lady who runs the Penguin Plunge, which is the event we're going to be doing. And I thought it was going to be a cease and desist to be like, stop making your shitty podcast with our name.
Yeah.
It wasn't.
Shitty's a compliment.
It wasn't, which was great. They were actually very supportive. They're like, hey, if you need anything, let us know. Good luck fundraising. So we're going to have a little fundraiser. Like, not a fundraiser. We're going to have a jar up here. If you guys want to donate anything extra to the Special Olympics in New Hampshire, it's going to go straight to there. We're trying to put our whole team to the Penguin Plunge, which happens in February.
We're even trying to get band tuba.
Even band
tuba. Do you want to see band tuba in a Speedo? Oh,
no. Yeah. But, yes.
I think we should have a rule. If we raise $100 more than, like, everyone costs to get there. If we raise 100 more, we have to do a calendar shoot with just tuba and Speedos.
All right, now who would buy the tuba calendar?
Yeah. Everyone raise your hand if you want this.
Now, tuba, stand up real quick. Show the people what we're working with.
Everyone give a hand.
Yeah, all right. Yeah! He's so macho, he ripped a chair down. That's how buff he is. You want that on a calendar, everybody.
I think about him at night.
I hear him at night because he lives above me. Shane, you got something?
No. But no, in all in all seriousness though, we're just gonna buy McDonald's with it. So
we could do
a lot of McDonald's. Well, depends how generous you guys are. Yeah.
We're gonna donate it. We'll donate the McDonald's.
We'll give it to Tuba.
I've seen him eat 60
nuggets. This man has eaten 60 nuggets before.
It was more like 50 because he was really fucked up, but...
Tuba, do you think you can eat 60 nuggets again in a five-minute sitting?
Weird flex.
Yeah, fucking weird flex.
That sounds like a... All right,
guys, so
like
I do have a little game I want to do.
All right.
No.
Hopscotch?
It's called Mascot.
Nope.
So we have another podcast called the Inner Circle Sports Podcast, and we had a little segment where we talked about which mascots in sports we think we could beat in a fight. And I wanted to bring that to our show with, like, the different mascots in the world of, like,
already
products.
Got an answer.
I have some problematic ones. We'll get to those. Taylor, you might want to block your ears for some of them. but we're going to do just a simple game. We're going to go straight boxing style. I'm going to throw you guys out a mascot. I want you to tell me how many rounds you can last with him and who's going to win by, like, knockout.
We've gone over this. Most mascots are animals. I could beat most animals.
not a hippo.
Yeah, but that's a big animal.
They're lethal.
Crowd interaction is encouraged for this. Yes, if you guys want to throw out someone. One, I want to hear an animal from the crowd that you think Hunter thinks he could beat up. I want to hear this. If we got anyone.
Yeah. Please.
An ostrich?
I could fuck an ostrich up.
Dude,
kangaroo. Look at how small their head is. My brain's way bigger.
The mandrake. Ooh.
That's pretty.
The mandrake good. Would fuck us all up.
That's not an animal.
Horse-sized duck? Yeah. The classic.
Right. The Oregon duck?
Ooh.
I think I could.
The big red
dog. Fuck. No, dude, he's fucking gigantic. I already told you, big animals, I can't do. Small animals, done.
What about a lynx?
Yep.
You think could
go
lynx?
On?
Dude, I played soccer for so long, I can kick so hard.
All right, well, that leads me into my first mascot, the Gerber baby.
I'd fuck the Gerber baby up.
I thought you were going to say something 100% different.
One round?
One round. Is this like a Conor McGregor, like, 13-second knockout? Or like?
No, this is a Floyd Mayweather. Like, outside a boxing punch.
I need to ask a clarifying question.
Yeah.
The Gerber baby picture is like 20-something years old.
No,
are
no,
we
no,
talking the, like the baby
oh,
version?
Oh, like today?
Or,
yeah.
Like, are we talking Nirvana cover photo? Like,
yeah, I mean,
today?
It's a woman, but... Dave's also kind of a woman.
No, Gerber baby as it sits.
It's 2019.
Oh, what the fuck was that?
I spit everywhere.
Thanks for the beer.
No, Gerber baby as it stands. Let's say, Christina, how old's your baby?
Okay.
All right, 11 and a half week old baby. How
so,
long you lasted?
So when you put it like that, Christina, you're a lovely girl. I want to put that out there. I would not punch your baby. I want to make that very clear. I am not punching babies. However, if this is a fight for survival, if my girlfriend was on the line, I would have to punch it. Just once.
Now, Dave's girlfriend, would you punch a baby for Dave?
No. Yeah, that's understandable. Yeah, it's understandable.
All right, Hunter, how long you lasting with a 11-week-old baby? The Gerber baby.
11 rounds because I would, like... Mike Tyson the fuck out of that. Or Muhammad Ali, like, bob and weave.
So you're,
like
you're not going to throw a single punch to the 11th, but that one punch?
No, and then I'm going to kick it and get disqualified, so I don't think I win.
Jeez. You're just looking for blood at this
point.
Yeah,
I want to go, like, I want to go WWE tables, ladders, chairs, and just give him a mean elbow drop through a table.
Dude,
like, dude, this is a win.
You put me in a ring with that baby, I turn into Pat Mahomes.
We can make some
what row you land in that baby? It might be the more important question.
Fucking nosebleeds.
Right. All right, let's level up our baby skills then.
Yeah,
the E-Trade baby.
Oh.
You know that one
yeah,
who talks?
I remember him.
Okay, he was on every like commercial for
I
like
feel
4
like
years.
Since he talks, he's got like an elevated mind and he can just mind
he's
control.
He's like baby geniuses level?
Yeah, and he can just take over.
I was a baby
shout
genius.
Shout out baby genius. No, you weren't.
The E-Trade baby.
Don't lie to me. I know who you are now. You're not
I feel
a
like he could
genius.
Get shit done. I think I'm winning easy. But
yeah.
He's like a toddler. Toddlers are lasting
no,
a bit
No, but
longer.
He talks, bro.
Oh, I
can. Is he going to talk me into making financial investments and
no,
then fuck me up when
yeah,
I'm not looking?
Yes, but listen, man. I can make you rich with mybookie.ag. Listen here. Do not punch me. I will give you the code.
What's the code again?
I don't even know. Plunge is that, podcast? Something like that?
Is that Plunge? P-L-U-N-G-E Plunge?
I believe so.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, you got to try it. I don't know.
You fucking hurt us.
Let me know. All
right. We're getting more into children now. Lil Debbie.
Oh.
I would like to take a back seat in this conversation.
Yeah. I'll take a forward seat on this one. I, again, putting this out here, big advocate of Little Debbie snacks.
What's your favorite?
Ooh,
zebra cakes? Because that's mine.
Zebra cakes aren't bad. What are the, like, the fudge rounds? Yeah. Nutty bar? I hate
coffee cake.
Coffee cake. Yeah.
The coffee cakes.
I think
are
I'm
flames.
Going coffee cake.
Fuck Swiss rolls. I don't know who said that.
Who said Swiss rolls?
Cosmic brownies are trash. I agree with that statement. But.
Whoa, okay. All right, well, everyone back off.
All right. I also enjoy eating chalk.
A round of applause for Cosmic Brownies.
Woo! Yeah! Obesity!
All right, round of applause. All right, Brad, it's just you. You hate Cosmic Brownies, and that's it. So I guess you're right.
I'll take a win.
Hold on,
let's
do that again. Four Cosmic Brownies? Woo! Yeah, fuck you, Slavey.
Now, Dave, that's not the question, though.
No, Little Debbie's the question.
Yes.
And I'm kicking Little Debbie in the face for a Cosmic Brownie.
Giving her a little taste of that sweet chin music.
I like the idea of this being a boxing match, but me and Dave are both like, now we're going to fucking kick him.
You're kickboxing.
No, because think of it like this, right? You kick Little Debbie in the face. Think of the headlines for tomorrow. 22-year-old adult kicks Little Debbie in the face for Cosmic Brownie. First off, that launches my career right there. I'm done with the Punch podcast forever.
But Dave, that launches you in the type of career where you have your middle name is associated to you.
Right. Yeah,
that's
dude.
That's that president killer status.
At that point,
like
you become
David
a
Michael
walking
Colford kicked Little Debbie in the face.
It's better than not kicking Little Debbie in the face, right? Think of it like this. And then I have a PR campaign that's like, all right, I apologize for my actions. I'm sorry. I'm going to sign with Little Debbie for a year, get free Cosmic Brownies, use promo code MyBookie.
Who's your childhood hero? Jared from Subway?
No.
All right, next. Okay, all right, yeah, next mascot. Jared from Subway. What you got?
I hope we can all agree on this
one. No, dude. I would not fuck with Jared from Subway. He's fit.
I'll kick Jared from Subway's ass.
Well, he's
dude,
got
I'm
AIDS.
I'm doing it for Little Debbie, man. Yeah, we're... Make them
hey, listen, clean. As people who have connections to the producers of Sharknado, I don't want to talk too much shit about Jared from Subway.
What,
but I'm going to give Jared from Subway.
Excuse the fuck me? What does that mean?
I was
what implications does that have?
Well, Jared from Subway was in two Sharknados.
Is he really?
No
now,
way.
Wait, what's he doing in those two Sharknados? Because that's going to say a lot about
touching
it.
Kids.
Okay, all
no,
right.
No. Touching tornado sharks.
Yes, and they're real.
My bad. It's an easy mistake.
All right, what round are you taking? Or is Jared from Subway taking you down?
Jared from Subway you taking me the whole way and winning by decision from the judges.
So you're just going to run from Jared from Subway.
Yeah, I don't think. Dude, I already
there's
going to
be zero punches thrown, but he's going to win.
I have enough trauma.
Okay. All right, I want to get into some serious ones, some haymaker type people.
Yeah.
This one, I think, is...
Mike Tyson.
Mr. Clean.
Mr. Clean?
Dude,
I feel like if you just bring out OxyClean, he'll run away right there.
Fuck no, that makes him stronger.
The thing I'm worried about with Mr. Clean is they never used to show his whole body, right?
No.
It used to just be his face. That chiseled smile, he looks like a handsome Howie Mandel.
He's
okay?
A thick boy.
But then they showed him with that thick ass, them sweet thighs going back and forth mopping.
God damn.
I think Mr. Clean would knock me out in the third and fucking mop up my tears.
I feel like he'd slap me with a
see how tight the white t-shirt is on him?
Yeah. Tight.
Tight.
he lifts. And he
Mr.
Fucks.
Clean lifts.
He lifts.
Listen, Mr. Clean fucks your wife when the husband's away. That's
and
all.
And then
I'm
he cleans
saying.
The house after.
I'm looking
it's
at you.
It's the perfect crime.
He's the best of both worlds.
Oh. He's the best of neither world.
Does Captain anyone? Crunch?
Oh, that's...
that's not a cleaning product.
Could you fight Captain... What about the Lucky Charms guy?
These are two different fights. Tag teaming it. Me and Hunter versus Captain Crunch and...
El Gordito and El Pepito?
Yes. Those are our luchador personas, if you were wondering. Oh,
what about the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man?
Well, that's like asking, could I beat up Tuba? And the answer is yes.
Wow.
I could beat up Tuba.
Wow. I could not beat up Tuba. I'll say it.
Get the fuck over here.
Yeah, Tuba, you want to fight? You want to contend? Do you have a contest? All right. The Michelin Man, you can't punch.
The
he's
Michelin
like,
Man himself?
The Michelin Man's like SpongeBob. When you punch him, he's just like, ha! Like, thank you.
He's just like that. He laughs exactly like that.
But then he's got tires in his arm, so it'll fuck you up.
I don't think you know who the Michelin Man is either.
He's just a bunch of white fluffies.
Yeah.
Look, we don't
he's like the Pillsbury Doughboy on steroids.
We don't see color here.
Yeah, he you're right.
Thank you, Will. All right.
Back up to B team.
I got one. Okay.
Nope, back to D team.
Let's hear it.
Yeah, I want to hear it, buddy.
Like, just the just all right, I guess this goes back to Hunter's original question. Could you beat up a lion?
I'm smarter than a lion.
Okay.
Huh? Dude, do you see how big my head is?
Do you see this?
Yeah, you
see this? Do you see this?
I missed
all right,
it.
I got you.
A drink, whoever said
who
that.
Said that? Was that you?
Who
Hunter's dick is like a bop it button, okay? Oh, next topic.
Oh, my God.
Shit goes inside.
The lion from Looney Tunes. No, it's a lion. He's going to fucking eat me.
What? Dude, wait, in a boxing match? No.
Oh, he doesn't have thumbs.
You're right. Yeah.
I don't know how that changes my answer, but I guess yes.
You're going to headbutt a lion?
Dude, my head gets bigger. My head expands by 0.1% every day. I'm achieving critical mass. I'll fuck that lion up.
He's at peak.
Huh? Yeah. And then you're welcome.
All right, what about the Six Flags guy?
Is he still alive? I haven't seen that
dude,
man
he might.
In years.
All right, fine. Dead Six Flags guy. How you
still no? That's still a hard no.
B Team Bin Bin's gonna weekend at Bernie's him and throw him in a boxing ring. Oh, I got a beer. Thanks, Tuba.
There you go, buddy.
All right,
you're still banned.
What about?
Brandy Love. Oh,
that's
shit.
That's my favorite mascot.
Hold on.
Dun-dun.
Brandy Love has been there for me at my darkest of times. I
will
never fight
her. She's there for me now.
I will never fight her.
I could fuck up Brandy Love. That's
I got a good one. Hunter, the mascot for the Oilers. It's a big cat.
No one knows what the fuck that is.
It's
next
a big
cat.
I fucking told you what it was. What do you mean you don't know what it is?
No one cares about the Edmonton Oilers.
I do.
Oh.
Now we're talking.
That's a scary motherfucker. Now I don't want to see him in the
ring. So what were you saying about a next topic?
That dude's laying in it, light heavyweight, all right? I don't know if I want to fuck with Ronald McDonald.
I'll
do you one better. Grimace, I don't want to get in the fucking ring with. Or his Grimace King half-brother, King Gunga.
Grimace is...
King Gunga is going to fuck me up, but I think Grimace
I
have a chance
with.
Is
it me, or does Riley have too far of an extensive knowledge of McDonald's mascots?
I know everything...
Is that the inner fat kid coming out?
No. I don't know everything about the McDonald's etymology, but I know everything about the Grimace etymology, including his sister and his cousin, King Gunga.
That's an interesting way to put it as etymology.
Thank you.
Why'd you say his sister first? That's what I want to know.
He's got sisters.
Family strokes. next... Yeah, no, we'll wait.
What's up?
Next topic.
Oh, you want the next mascot?
Sure.
Hey, hey, Taylor, what's your favorite kind of rice?
Oh, shit.
Oh, I thought it was going to be Uncle Ben's. Uncle Ben!
Shit. Rest in peace.
Do I get a gun?
Nah, he's old. Like, him and Famous Amos, like, they're old. Like, I feel like you're good. Yeah.
That might be a record for worst segue of all time. There's nothing in that cup. What are you doing?
We got like audience cam. That was amazing. So Uncle Ben, we'll even do a tag team of
me
of,
and Dave. Me
of,
and Just
yeah,
Dave.
Yeah, we'll do a tag team of
Dave.
Famous Amos and Uncle Ben, two elderly black men.
I'll take Uncle Ben.
Uncle? Oh, I thought you were talking about Spider-Man.
No,
YouTube.
Oh, the rice, man.
got it.
The rice. What are you guys? How are you guys doing? I'm gonna say it's a tag team between you two.
It's close.
I mean, look, I know I'll carry my weight.
Ladder match, WWE style.
Ooh. How in a cell?
No. Just a ladder
just a
match.
Ladder match. Can you lift a ladder?
Can you?
I know I can. Can you? It's a real question. Or I'm looking for a new partner.
You don't have a choice, and the answer is no.
Well,
do you see that. These delicate hands?
Oh, I see those delicate hands. Give me them.
I don't like this.
This is good shit.
Who's winning?
Us,
can you
course.
Leave us the fuck alone? We're having a moment.
Touch his mustache. You've been challenged. You've been challenged to hold hands for the rest of the show. She will donate $20 if you hold hands for the rest of the show.
That
hold hands.
By the way,
if you detach once,
get ready for the extreme sweat storm that's about to happen.
This isn't a challenge, by the way.
All right. We do this every time we get in the car.
Yeah, we do.
All right, Kool-Aid man.
No, absolutely not.
He's got
absolutely
a hard
not.
Head. He's made of glass.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What if we can tag team 2-on-1?
Okay.
Still no?
But you have to keep holding. You have to keep holding hands, though. So.
No, then it's like Red Rover and we fucking crack them.
No, we can just clothesline them.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
We just run.
You just got to spill them. That's all you got to do.
Is that his life force?
Yeah, it's his blood.
That's what gives him power.
He's got to drain his blood.
That's fucked up, man.
Oh, no.
I didn't need that in my life, and now I'm not going to sleep tonight. Thanks, man.
Yeah, Kool-Aid Man, wait, I don't know, man. He clocks in at 6'7", 480 pounds. Can you handle that super heavyweight?
Do you want to get in on this?
No.
Okay.
Can we do not at all. I'm not on that. I got to keep going down from my mic, so. Colonel Sanders.
We got a diva.
Colonel Sanders. That's
he's got an army, similar to Captain Crunch. I don't know if I want to fuck with him, because you know in like WWE when people have managers, like Undertaker brings out Paul Bearer and he fucks with the people?
Yeah.
Like, Captain Crunch just has a fucking army out there.
You say Captain Crunch or Colonel Sanders?
Both. They both have an army. They are high-ranking officials in
Captain
the United
Crunch
States
has
military.
Captain Crunch has a fleet. Colonel Sanders has an army. Go back to college.
I got nothing. All right. our final person of the night. Aunt Jemima.
Yes. Jemima.
I could fuck Aunt Jemima up. Hands down.
Again, I thought you were going to end one word earlier.
I know where you're going. Nope. Her pancakes are shit.
Oh,
I'll go on the record and say
that. I mean, she makes syrup.
That.
I was going to, yeah.
No, she makes pancakes, the little ones.
Yeah, she makes pancakes.
Yeah.
Mom has pancakes? Major pancakes?
Yeah.
Major pancakes? Okay.
He's second in command to Colonel Sanders.
Hunter, my hands are already getting sweaty. This is going to be rough, man.
Don't want to do this. I will pay $20 myself if
you guys
stop.
Have 22 minutes to go.
You will pay $20.
I will pay $20.
No.
Are you anyone want to double down to make them keep you'll double down?
No.
We're doubling down to $40 now to keep you holding hands.
One in?
Sir, what is your fascination with
you'll
this?
You'll do another $20?
We're at 60.
What?
Wait,
stop.
So you'll match $20 and you'll match $20?
Oh,
all right, 60
man.
Bucks now to the bin.
Yeah,
to special.
We can't.
Do you hate special needs kids? You're going to unlatch because you're sweaty? Fuck you.
We're doing it for the kids, Hunter.
How much for a kiss? Oh!
Name your price. I'm game.
Wait,
$100?
This is consensual. Wait.
$100? I'll take it.
Deal.
Oh, God damn it.
Give me that shit.
Discover card.
Is that a second kiss for the BJ's card?
That is cheap gas.
Boys, the crowd has bought a shot, so I'm going to hand this to your appropriate hand because you're going to keep holding it because we have $60 on the line.
A shot?
Oh, boy.
What's this a shot of, Shane?
Yeah, what kind of shot? Depression?
Jameson, okay.
Oh, thanks, man.
All right, well.
I'm 19.
Thank
I'm
you.
Just
thanks.
I'm just kidding. I'm just
shout
kidding.
Out,
I
shout out
my
roommate
ID.
Shane. And cheers, boys.
Shout out roommate
shout
Shane.
Shout out Charity. Don't
I
you unlock those hands.
I have early in the morning, so thank you. Cheers,
cheers,
buddy. Cheers.
I don't know why we both kept our hands
right,
over the
on.
Mic.
Woo. Thanks. You don't like Jameson, Dave? Oh, you got it down? Okay. All right, if anyone wants to buy a gift card, Jesus. if anyone wants to
has one right. shot.
Woo! Has one shot. Fucked up. Yeah.
Hey, you were coming, guys.
All right. We have two more segments to get to. We have an old segment we're going to bring back tonight called Plunge Picks, called Jump Ball. It's
Ooh.
A segment we do on the show where we bring up a topic with two extreme sides, and we duke it out. Luckily
Mean
tonight,
Dave versus the audience.
yeah, listen, we want you guys involved in this as well. We can have a live vote for who won at the end. So we're going to do some jump ball here. Our first topic, ranch or blue cheese?
Ranch, all the
ranch.
Way.
Ranch!
Oh.
Hey, you're blue cheese. We get to pick first.
Blue cheese. All right, audience, who gets to state their case first?
Me.
Team Ranch? All right. The floor is yours.
Am I just Team Ranch?
No, it's you.
We're both team.
We are
team collective.
Ranch? God damn, we're going home tonight, man. We are. All right, here's
I'm
what.
I'm getting laid.
Here's why we are Team Ranch. Number one, me and Hunter are still going to hold hands after this. We're going to get a whole bathtub of ranch. And we're just going to take a dip. Also, ranch is good on buffalo wings. That's
also, what else are you going to put on your pizza crust? Not going to be fucking blue cheese.
No.
Yes,
that
it is.
Shit's gross.
Yeah, you have. Those are terrible points. Because your point is, what are you going to dip pizza crust in? Literally anything else. Your point is, oh, it tastes good on wings. So does blue cheese. It tastes superior to wings.
I didn't know you were on a team.
Yeah, I am team blue cheese. You guys are together. Fuck both of you.
Blue cheese is the best.
Hey. You had your chance. It's my turn now.
Shut your mouth and close that half open hand.
I am happy for you. All right. Yeah, oh, blue cheese is mold. Delicious mold. Okay? No, All cheese is mold. Do you know what mayonnaise is? Mold eggs. Fuck you, blue cheese is the best.
No, no. Let me tell
you why. Cheese is also mold, you fucking halfwit.
What are you gonna
You know what ranch is? Ranch is for children. You dip your carrots in it because you think it tastes too yucky. Hey, all right, hey. You have to add ranch to it. Ranch is for children, you're a child. You just don't have a sophisticated palate.
At least we can put ranch on everything else.
Okay, yeah, the floor is yours again.
No. I'm calling timeout.
Okay.
We need to sign. Alright, I think we should.
Applebee's girl cut us off after three drinks, so obviously her opinion is wrong.
She knew you liked blue cheese, that's why.
Okay, can we have our time out now?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I think we should hit him with, you can use ranch for everything else.
Ranch is applicable as lube.
I mean, I've used ranch for sex.
Have you ever used blue cheese?
Hey, shut the fuck up, we're in timeout.
Yeah, that sounds like a solid plan, though. You down?
Yeah, I'm down.
Okay,
all right, end timeout.
All right, we're back.
You can use ranch as lube.
And
what do you got of that?
And
huh?
Blue cheese is only good for wings. What else are you going to use blue cheese for? Please tell me. Salad dressing. Who eats salads? This is America. Come on.
You don't look like you eat salads.
Oh, my God. Okay. All right. Taylor, I love you, buddy. Don't let
I love you, too.
No, but I'm holding hands with him, though. I'm not involved.
You're fighting both of us.
No, you're not. No, you're not.
Is that it? Your counter is you can put ranch on everything?
You can put ranch on everything. You can use it as a sex toy if you're really that adventurous.
Anything's a sex toy, so we can't really use that.
I saw that over there.
Oh, also, guys, for any of you who want after the show, we got stickers and packets of Spunk Lube for all of you. So see us after the show. Yeah. Yep. Okay, so the fact that you think the fact that ranch goes on everything just says to my point that you're wrong. Do you want a food that's so plain that you can put it on everything? No, you want something that has.
Sorry, I wasn't listening because you're wrong.
Yeah, I want ranch on anything that is good.
Why would you want that? Why would you want it better?
If someone buys me,
do you
a shot
just
of
not
ranch,
like food enough that you have to dip ranch on everything?
Do you not like? Do
you, so it just
enough?
Shows me yeah, you're a child. Gonna,
are you, do you not like food enough that you can't not put blue cheese on it?
That's my case exactly. I think we won.
Fucking preach. Facts from the crowd. Points.
It's a real shame. It's a real shame. All right, everyone, raise your hands. Make some noise if you are Team Ranch. Let's hear it. I want Team Ranch.
All right. Yeah.
You gonna fight against that?
You're yelling into a mic. This shouldn't count.
The door is right there, sir.
You know how the Seahawks amp in noise? That's you right now.
Hey, I'm holding hands.
This is close.
That's close.
It's pretty close.
I think we win though. Huh? I think we win.
Almy, what do you pick?
Ranch.
Yeah, you trusted a man who looks like Steven Seagal on testosterone pills? Come on. He does.
I do.
That is a real man. God, don't you love America?
I do ranch enemas. It's great for your health. That's why I look 18.
I inject ranch instead of insulin.
That sounds like a bad idea. All right,
well,
on the topic of sugar,
our next jump ball
is
ketchup a smoothie.
Yeah.
No.
No.
100%.
No.
Nah.
No.
Tomatoes a fruit, blend it up, tomatoes a smoothie.
So I'm going to let you two duke this one out. I'll give the general opinion.
Wait,
tomatoes?
Are you saying that?
You two are duking it. Hey, hold it out, hold handers. Hold off. The general concept is.
They are.
That's a new one, Almy.
Make a fart noise?
That we don't need to.
All right. General consensus is, tomatoes are a fruit. Fruit blended into stuff is a smoothie. You two battle it out.
I'll let you go first since you're the number one.
No, be my guest. Okay. The hunt is the host, and you go first. So I'm bullying you into this.
I know where you live. Hear me out. Ketchup is a condiment. We all know that, right?
A trash condiment.
Okay, that's besides the point. Still
wrong.
A condiment, though. When you go to McDonald's, the birthplace of America,
That is where Ranch is
McDonald's
born.
Was founded in 1812.
You're damn right it was. And it's still here because it's that good.
When was the U.S. founded? 1776?
Something like that. I don't know. But hear me out. When you go to a health bar, which I know you don't, but when you go to a gym, which, again, I know you don't, do you get a smoothie? Yeah, can I get a ketchup smoothie, please? Extra ketchup? No, of course you don't do that.
Put some chup on that smoothie.
You're a psychopath if you do that. You're going to be put in this mental asylum. And I'm looking out for you, man. I really am looking out for you. And I want you to change course.
I don't like that you're gripping my hand a little bit tighter. Like, as the argument got more and more, like, aggressive, it was, like, squeezing and squeezing.
Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie. That's not who I am. Please don't call the cops on me. We can work this out.
Okay. May I go?
Yeah, of course.
May I pose a question to you?
I'm always down for
what is a smoothie?
What is a smoothie? It's fruit, not a condiment, blended into a blender, and it goes, and that's your smoothie. Just like that.
Okay. But the definition of a fruit is that the seeds are held inside. That was determined on taxes so that it would be cheaper to bring tomatoes into the country. Am I wrong?
Shut the fuck up.
So you brought fucking taxes into this.
I did, but am I wrong?
Yeah, you are wrong.
No, I'm not. According to the U.S. Constitution, tomatoes are fruit, and if you blend up a tomato, it becomes ketchup. Ketchup is a smoothie because blended fruit
is a
smoothie.
You're a psychopath. I'm taking a sidebar from Tuba.
Okay, to be fair, wouldn't that just be diced tomatoes?
Right.
That's not diced tomatoes.
It's
diced tomatoes.
Tomatoes, I guess. You're right. Yeah. Okay.
All right. I want
a smoothie blended.
Tuba.
Fruit and ice. That's a smoothie. Tomato and ice. Fruit. Fruit.
Is salsa a smoothie? Fuck. Okay.
Almi, I know you've been a supporter for us for about a year and a half, but the door is right there. Good.
No. Hey.
I will not accept
I think you're on to something.
Team
Waitresses,
Almi,
you know
you
food.
Stay right the fuck
is
there.
Is salsa a smoothie?
Yep.
No?
Nope.
Not even a little bit?
Hold on. No. I'd like to
what about ketchup?
No. I'd like to get the crowd.
Oh, all right. They're thinking about ketchup. They're like, all right. Ketchup
does
might be a smoothie.
Anyone in here, and I know you don't want to be, like, you know, segregated or pointed out, but hear me out. Is ketchup a smoothie? If you are.
Yeah!
All right. So we've got like, what, 30 to 2? I'll get
the
car started.
Yeah, but you know what? How much noise did you hear for not a smoothie? Yo, do
it. Ladies and gentlemen, if you think ketchup is not a smoothie, please join up with me. Clap
if
your
you
hands.
Make
some
noise. No,
everyone, if you think ketchup is not a smoothie, that is my campaign promise for 2020.
That shit was weak. Two people just made more noise than 30.
Okay, all right.
What do you mean? Wait, ha! Yeah, get me a shot of ketchup. I'll take it right now.
Do we have?
Can we do that? Can we do that?
Do we
you have ketchup?
Can you do a shot?
Do you have
of ketchup?
Can you get a shot glass full of ketchup?
I will pay you
please,
$5 right now if you can get us a shot
yes.
of ketchup. Actually, can you?
You did it to yourself,
thank you so much.
Dumb dumb.
Hey, look at me. Is ketchup still a smoothie?
I'm going to say, if I take it, do I win?
No, absolutely not. Absolutely
in your
not.
Mind, when you said that, did you think we weren't at a bar that had neither ketchup nor shot glasses? What?
You know what? Hey, shut the fuck up, D-Team Well. You know what they say. The age-old saying, fortune favors the bold.
I've never heard of that.
Dude, you're gonna have to finger that shit out like a Jello shot.
Yeah, you can't do that. You dip it. It's like a dairy blizzard, man. You flip that over. That's not coming out. You're gonna have to get sexual with that. I want to see some ton action. Show me what you do on Thursday night to me, to that ketchup shot.
Dude, I'll take it like a Jello shot.
Please do. You're gonna puke all over me. All
right, guys. As much as I'd love to continue, we're gonna make him take this shot of ketchup. But as much as I'd love to continue where we're going here, we have to start wrapping up.
Wait, before we continue. Do I have permission to let go so that I can use the both hand strategy?
No,
Skyler?
Right? No.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to help me. You're gonna have to finger his chup, bro.
I'll help you, buddy.
Yeah. Yes.
We do that with our dicks and Chinese finger traps.
I didn't.
The secret is getting soft.
I did not consent.
That's
to that.
The hard part.
That is a big shot glass. Oh my god. Dude, you're done.
You got permission?
Thank you so much. What's your name?
Thank you, Josh from Curlies,
thank
for letting
so
us
much,
take
Kendra.
A shot at. Oh my god,
man,
that's full.
I present this to you. Your smoothie. Raise it up to show everyone what this looks like.
That's a smoothie right there.
That is a smoothie?
It's like the equivalent of like espresso, but it's a smoothie.
That's a V8. That's a V8.
So it's like
right
condensed
there,
flavor shots?
I need your help.
Cheers. Well, see cheers, how much brother. You can get down. Yeah. Oh.
You're so close. Do it for daddy.
Dude, all right, now tongue that shit.
Oh, my God.
And did it have... Oh.
Dude. I fuck with ketchup.
And did it taste smoothie-ish?
Yeah. It's good.
It's a smoothie? A good smoothie? Oh.
You have to finish that whole thing.
Put that. Did you hear the slurp?
I heard this. I heard everything, man. Put that on your Tinder bio. Chicks a lot... All the ladies in the crowd. All
right, guys, we got to wrap. Get to this last segment. All right, every week we wrap our episodes with a segment we do called Plunge Picks. It is a thing where we pretty much do a draft snake style, where we pick our best four of a certain topic. And this week, well, Hunter, in between ketchup slurps, you want to tell them who this Plunge Picks is brought to you by?
It's brought to you by Official Clothing. It is a clothing line brought to you by the homie Casual, who is one of the hosts of the Hood Diner podcast.
I love that guy.
Me fucking too.
I'm meeting him in like 5 days.
I'm jealous. Really like that guy. Also, shout out brother Mikey for not having your house burned down.
His house burned down.
Oh, did?
No, it didn't. No.
Oh, yeah. That's
I'm
what
still
I said.
Going out, so yeah.
Yeah. Go out and check out their stuff. They have unique logos and remakes of old logos, so definitely check it out. Affordable and comfortable. Use promo code PLUNGE for your first checkout for 25% off.
Woo! Woo. So that's official. Official.
Let me hear clothing. A round of applause for the homie casual.
We love the homie casual.
That's not enough. I want more.
We love.
Let me hear some effort.
Thank you. Thank you.
And this week we are doing our plunge picks. This is one we've been waiting a while for.
We
are doing plunge picks of best Lil Wayne bars. All right. Indeed.
I love Nickelback.
Taylor, you are so clearly the only black man in this city.
Don't you love Coldplay?
Yeah, my favorite song is Yellow Submarine.
Yeah, that's a really good one.
All right, so we are doing our plunge picks.
By the way, is this enough? I can't get my tongue any further.
I mean, you're not making any money from this. I don't know.
No, you got to keep going.
I can't.
No, you got to keep going. I want to see you clean. Oh, yeah.
Well, you can't.
No. I didn't sign up for this. Wow. This guy.
Finger me, Riley.
Not fingering you, no.
No.
I can't get the bottom.
All right, so
punch picks going.
All right, so what we do. No, I'm not holding you. You want me to put it down?
Yeah. Okay. I'm done. I can't get the bottom.
All right.
You did good, boy. You did good.
What do you say?
To give you a straw.
You're an animal.
Get it.
We do have a straw right there.
All right, we gotta put a bow on this.
Yes.
All right, so. We do draft order, snake style. So we're going to go Dave, Hunter, Riley. Riley, Hunter, Dave. We're going to do four total rounds.
I'm ready. All right. I think this is the best.
I have lines. I don't remember them.
Lil Wayne lyric out there. Fight me outside the parking lot. You'll probably win.
I'll eat your ass.
Real G's move in silence like lasagna. My favorite Nickelback song.
I'll be honest, I didn't think we'd be getting rounds of applause for Lil Wayne lyrics.
In 2019, yeah, I didn't think so either. All right, Hunter, what do you got, buddy?
I don't remember them because I picked them a while ago, but I got Your Flow Never Wet, like Grandma.
You, no, no, that's my list, you motherfucker.
Oh, why the fuck did you send it to me? Oh, mine's Hit Dora with a Pan, Call That Shit Pandora.
Could you fight Little Debbie and Dora? That's the...
Wayne yes.
Yeah, all right, so I'm up for two. I'm going to take 7 grams in the blunt, almost drowned in the pussy, so I swam to the butt. Butt. It's keep going, yeah.
Lil Wayne, is that you?
Yeah. Oh, you shave your hair?
Wow.
Looks good.
Wow. Yeah, keep going. All right, the next one I got is I tongue kiss her other tongue, skeet, skeet, skeet. Water gun.
That's
oh
my
God, Becky, look at her butt. Toochie.
That is literally my favorite line.
That's my favorite J. Cole song.
That's right. My favorite Nickelback song.
All right, so Hunter, back jokes. To you.
I got poked a Jamaican, call that bitch Pokemon. Yeah, dude, I'm basically Jamaican.
I love it. All right.
Taylor?
I
am Jamaican. Are you?
He is actually Jamaican.
Hey! Brother, sister, girl.
All righty, moving on.
Right, Dave, you're up for two.
Up for two. Well, I found this one out yesterday, and I actually cried laughing, so I hope you all cry with me. It's not my depression, I promise. Push to nun in a wheelchair, call that Virgin Mobile. Now that right, so is Dave, quality.
That's
right
a
there.
Good one right that there.
It's so good.
That's
that
strong. That with all G's moving silence like that's exactly. Strong. Oh, punch.
Looking strong. Me and Jackie are doing that for Halloween, by the way.
Lil Wayne?
You're going to yeah. be a lasagna?
I'm going to be the priest.
Is that why you asked me the other day if I had a wheelchair?
Yeah. It's not what you think it is. All right, here
nah,
we go.
Nah, he's going to put that pussy in a wheelchair.
Jesus. Wait, well, Dave, you're up for one more.
Yep. Okay, here we go. This one, by the way, RIP. He's a good man. I keep on switching.
Weinstein? No. Wait, is it no. Weinstein?
We're going to keep going. We're going to keep going. RIP. I keep on switching wifeys. You got to Uncle Phil me in.
Ooh. Okay.
RIP.
Can you Uncle Phil me up?
He's dead, so I can't.
All right, Hunter, you're up.
I think you guys are fuck. I'm not going to lie. I didn't have time to pick because I was really busy with school, so they picked for me. I don't think that this is a Lil Wayne line. I think this is a Justin Bieber line, but I'll roll with it. It says, and I was like, baby, 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 oh.
You got to finish it, man. You got to finish it. He does. He does.
I don't know the end of the line. Does he do it again?
If you go in the bedroom with him,
all right. So
more.
I'm up for my last two.
Yeah,
I got Tunchi, Tunchi, Tunchi. I don't love them hoes. Got so much coke, you gonna need another nose, man.
Why'd you point at Christian for that?
I don't know. It's a big coke guy over there. Big coke guy.
Okay, all right.
And then my last pick. Your flow never wet like grandma pussy. I'm always good like grandma's cookies.
I almost picked that one on accident.
I love grandma's cookies.
That sounds kind of familiar, though.
Shout out, grandma. You always burned your cookies, but I'm still here for you.
Would you eat grandma pussy?
What the fuck
we don't have time for that. That would be another week. God. See, Almy's like, yep.
Almy's like, I'll take seconds. I guess my last one is, I'm through with standing in lines to clubs. I'll never get in. So I have the weakest
no,
shit.
I
fuck
think,
you guys.
No, I picked your last one. Is your last one is, I'm all about the riches. My name should be Richard.
I'm doing standing in lines and clubs. I'm never kidding.
It's like the bottom of the ninth, and I'm never giving in. That's all I got.
This we built this.
Oh, it's so good. All right.
Listen, if this is what our fan base is, I'm fine with it.
Honestly.
I listen to Nickelback at the gym, no cap.
I really want to unwrap hands after that call. I really do. I'm tempting.
We could fill a Dasani water bottle right now.
Jesus. These are slimy. All right, here we go.
All right, and wrap us up, Dave.
Ladies and gentlemen, to finish up the night, this one hits personal to me. These sluts is on my nuts. I feel like granola. It was so good we had to drop the bar.
Shit on my nuts.
I thought that, all right, so the shadow, I'm going to be honest, the shadow made it look like you pissed yourself. And I really was like, oh, we're not going there, are we?
I did, but the whole pants are wet.
Yeah, good man.
All right, we got a couple minutes. I wanted to do one last
empty
topic.
Yeah, let's do it.
Is there just an agreed upon best song in the world?
Yeah, Rockstar by Nickelback.
No, it's the alphabet.
Okay, no.
It's the new alphabet song.
L M N. But like, there's got to be one that everyone's just like, yeah, that's the best one, right? Bohemian
Rhapsody. Shut your mouth, tuba.
Africa by Toto.
Like, only Africa by Toto, but it has to be in alphabetical order.
But, like, there's got to be some songs out there where you can just say one line and everyone in the room will just immediately just like, oh, wait. We're halfway there.
Whoa!
Yeah, yo.
That shit's weak. Hey, now.
Go play. Hey, now.
Taylor, what's your favorite song, buddy?
A Millie.
Oh, my man.
Just a small town
fellas,
girl.
Got it. Crocodiles in Paris.
Living in a lonely world.
Yeah.
Stop trying to push for that. That shit's weak.
Yeah, Family Guy made that popular.
Everyone knows that it's Enter Sandman by Metallica.
All right, well, that'll do it from us tonight. We want to thank you all very much for coming out. Thank you guys so much for driving all the way out here. We appreciate it so much.
Seriously, thank you all so much. I love you.
We did it.
You, and you owe us $20 each. Shout out.
Advocating for paying us.
Huge shout out to PodcastNH and especially Meter for putting all this together.
Also, huge shout out to Curlies Comedy Club for
hosting us
today.
Huge shout out to Curlies. Thank you, Josh, for putting this all together.
Thank you, Curlies, for the ketchup shot that made my night right there.
Pod-Tober has been a huge success, and I'm glad to cap it out with a sellout crowd here. So thank you guys so much. It's meant the world to us. We can't thank you more for coming out and showing support. You guys are why we keep doing this and
listening to our shitty comedy.
It makes us sleep at night, so thank you.
It does it. It keeps me up at night.
Yeah. Once again, shout out to everyone. Shout out to the Inner Circle Podcast Network. Go check out a bunch of shows. Like we have a bunch of network. We have a bunch of shows like Shit Happens When You Party Naked. Team Almy. We got the Simmons and More podcast.
Wait.
Father Almy.
Jason's our dad.
He's our dad. Boogie woogie. That's the thing
dad.
We used
Papa
to do.
Papa Almy.
Shout out to the Simmons and More podcast, hashtag No Offense Show, Failing Hollywood, the Hood Diner podcast, the Joby Show. I got you, buddy.
you took that from me.
And shout out to all of our exclusive stuff. We have stickers. We have lube.
Me and Dave have to take all of it.
Please take the lube.
If you guys want to make a donation, it would be huge after the show if you want to come see us. All proceeds are going to the Special Olympics of New Hampshire. It's going to go to a big thing. So if you guys want to come make a donation after, that'd be awesome.
If you want to see...
Yeah, listen, if you guys make the money to make them kiss, that'll be a good wrap. That'll be a good button to the show. Everyone give $5.
100. 100 total. What do you say? To me?
No, you guys are both too bad at fantasy to make this deal. Alright, shout out to all you guys. Come see us after the show. And thank you all so much. Thank you, Curlies Comedy Club. Thank you guys.
Thank you so much. Please take the lube.
Give a bow.
Are we doing a bow? Oh yeah.
A bow.
Wait, are we doing it?